दोस्तों थैंक यू वेरी मच फॉर योर पेशेंस. काफ़ी लंबे समय बाद मैं डिक्टेशंस आपको प्रोवाइड कर रहा हूँ. गला थोड़ा सा ठीक नहीं था, कोल्ड था, कोल्ड का असर भी थोड़ा सा है, बट कोशिश करूँगा आपको डिक्टेशन सही से प्रोवाइड करने की. ग्रेट सी का मैटर है, 1000 वर्ड्स की डिक्टेशन होगी, 100 WPM इसकी स्पीड होगी, आपको डिक्टेशन प्रोवाइड कर रहा हूँ, बी रेडी फॉर इट. मिस्टर चेयरमैन सर, आई राइज टू सपोर्ट द मोशन ऑफ थैंक्स on the president's address. I am very happy to participate in this discussion. It is a memorable moment for me. As we observed yesterday, the address was delivered by a woman of our country. The chair of Lok Sabha, to which we are addressing all our speeches, is also occupied by a woman. Sir, next to God, we are all indebted to women for our lives and then for making our lives worth having. Throughout the history, we find that all the great changes have been brought about by women at the beginning. Sir, the presidential address is an indication of women empowerment and poor people's entitlement. The presidential address is a sign of social revolution in our country. Sir, here one honorable member, while deliberating on the motion of thanks, was narrating the vision of our India. I would like to tell him that we have taken steps such as signing the Indo-US nuclear deal, which led us to get rid of ourselves from the nuclear apartheid that we had been facing for the last 3.5 decades. The salient features of the president's address are an inclusive society and an inclusive economy. This government, since its inception, has been continuing its endeavor to the direction of the poor and the vulnerable sections of our society. In our constitution, powers have been separated. In our constitution, duties and responsibilities have been clearly demarcated. Here, we should not confuse between the union list, the state list, and the concurrent list. That is the main problem. Being Indians, we should be proud that we have been able to launch a mission to moon by virtue of our scientists and the technologists, which was built indigenously. We should be proud of knowing it, that it is the constant endeavor of our scientists and the technologists that we have been selected in a club of a few countries which possess the intermediate range missiles. It is to defend our country, to defend our sovereignty, and to defend the freedom that we have acquired by the sweat and blood, by the sacrifice of the freedom fighters of our country. Sir, I would also like to express my gratitude to this government, as they are going to introduce a legislation for giving right to food. This is also a historic legislation, like Mahatma Gandhi National Rural Employment Guarantee Act. I would also propose to this government that in tandem with the right to food, the right to work, government should consider the right to health. If it is considered, then I think most of the people of our country will get benefit. Sir, our government is pressing hard to harness the talent of our country. Educational loan to the tune of ₹25,000 crore have been disbursed to 16 lakh students of our country, because without knowledge, India cannot prosper further. Now, this government should make further endeavor to harness our demographic resources because it is a golden opportunity for us. If we invest more and more in the educational sector and the skill development sector, then the coming generation will have a great opportunity because we are enjoying the demographic dividend in the world. Sir, the President's address has laid stress on small and medium scale enterprises. As we know, crores of unemployed youth of our country could earn their livelihood if small and medium sector is revived and is given more teeth. Therefore, small and medium sector industries can play a very contributory role in the economic development of our country. This government has put in place three major instruments. First of all, an amount of rupees 25,000 crore has been earmarked for the National Farmers Development Scheme. The second is the National Food Security Mission, and the third is the National Horticulture Mission. All these instruments are very much in the direction to make further growth in our agriculture. Sir, this government again is putting emphasis for the universalization of secondary education. Not only that, for higher education also the government is taking special care, and therefore the government is stressing for excellence, inclusion and expansion. Sir, another thrust area should be rural water supply. I come from the state of West Bengal. Water of 8 districts of the state of West Bengal has been contaminated by arsenic. We are simply sitting on arsenic bomb, but there is no infrastructure which can deliver any remedy to the arsenic affected people of our state of West Bengal. I know that other states are also suffering from contamination of water with arsenic, fluoride, etc. Sir, the state government of West Bengal has become financially bankrupt, so they cannot provide the requisite sum which has to be put as a matching grant. All the funds which have been flowing from the national exchequer are lying idle in the state of West Bengal. Therefore, I would request the government to vigorously monitor the implementation of such schemes so that the funds meant for drinking water and for other public welfare measures should be used in an optimal way. Sir, I must thank this government for ushering in a new hope for the backward and poor people of our country. The government has already declared a 15-point program for the downtrodden people of our country in pursuance of the recommendations of a committee set up on this regard. Various facilities relating to education of their children, free midday meal in schools, loans for farmers and rural households, etc., will be provided under this program. This is very essential, keeping in view the vision of our great father of the nation, that if we could serve the last person standing in the queue and who is in the desperate need, then only we can develop our nation. So, all these steps are in the right direction to achieve that vision. Schemes are important, but the success of the scheme depends on its implementation. So, we have to see the implementation part also. Lastly, I thank you very much for giving me this opportunity to place my views on the presidential address. So, दोस्तों इसी के साथ ये dictation finish होती है और उम्मीद कर रहा हूँ आप लोगों ने बहुत अच्छे से लिखा होगा matter को. ज़्यादा tough नहीं है, कुछ एक words इसमें ऐसे आए हैं जो आपको problem दे सकते हैं, तो उनकी आप लगातार practice करते रहिए. आपसे मुलाकात करूँगा अब मैं अगली class में इसी dictation को लेकर 110 WPM के साथ. तब तक के लिए बाय-बाय, take care.